Alan, thanks for watching Proactive New York. AIM ImmunoTech has announced the start of an NCI-funded Phase 2 study of its product candidate Ampligen in melanoma. Joining me with more is the company's CEO, Tom Equels. Tom, good to see you again.
And Steve, it's great pleasure to be here with you again. Thank you.
Pleasure. So Tom, can you give an overview of the new NCI-funded Ampligen trial and AIM's prior findings in melanoma?
It'd be my pleasure. This trial is very important because we've been clinically exploring Ampligen's synergistic effect with a number of different immunotherapies, but principally checkpoint blockade therapies. Now, this new trial in melanoma, which is a 24-subject open-label trial, will allow us to test Ampligen in combination with chemokine modulation therapy, which is an interferon and celecoxib mix with Ampligen, and a dendritic cell vaccine. So it's an opportunity to see what Ampligen will do in that new combinational context. The trial, we believe, is very important because we have a prior signal in a pilot study we did with Ampligen alone in stage 4 melanoma. And if you could bring up the slide, please, related to the melanoma study, you'll see that in this small study, 9 subjects, we achieved a complete response in 2 of those subjects. So that's a very significant standalone impact of Ampligen on stage 4 melanoma. And if we can enhance that with this dendritic cell vaccine, we can make a big difference in terms of this lethal unmet medical need. That's our focus. And there's another aspect of this that I think is very important. This is a National Cancer Institute funded study in conjunction with Roswell. So this clinical trial, phase 2 clinical trial, is being paid for principally by grant funds. Now, if you could bring up our oncology pipeline slide, please, you will see that we have a number of significant clinical trials that are underway right now. And for the most part, almost exclusively, you will see that those clinical trials are being paid for by grant funds. For example, in advanced recurrent ovarian cancer, we have a phase 2 45 subject Ampligen plus pembrolizumab, that's the Merck drug Keytruda, underway at the University of Pittsburgh. That's almost fully funded by a Merck grant. So clinical trials in cancer are extremely important. So for investors, this is something that's important to know, that we're not using our capital to pay for these trials. In a way, we raise money where we're using NCI grants and Merck grants to pay for these trials that's non-dilutive. So we have probably tens of millions of dollars worth of clinical activity underway, or in the case of this melanoma study, getting ready to start, that is principally funded utilizing grant money. So that, I believe, is an important point for investors to understand.
Tom, can you talk about the phase 2 melanoma study and the patient population that's going to be enrolled?
Yeah, certainly. The patient population here will be, the actual population will be 24 subjects. But these subjects will be people who've sort of hit the end of the road in terms of therapeutic advantage, completed the standard of care and have nowhere else to go. And late stage melanoma is a highly lethal malignancy. So we're dealing with people that are, in some state of extremis. We hope to be able to help them with this combinational therapy.
What are the plans for the phase 2 melanoma study, and what do you expect will be the next steps if it's successful?
Well, we have some data where Ampligen by itself has a biomedical impact from that preliminary data in the pilot study with Ampligen in stage 4 melanoma. And this is not, it's a small study, so it's not statistically significant, but it certainly, two out of nine having a complete response is a strong signal, and it's showing some level of biological activity. We hope to improve upon that significantly in this combinational therapy. And if we're able to do that, and again, this is an open label, this is not a randomized control trial, it's 24 subjects, but if we're able to do that with those 24 subjects, we'll have a reasonably large number of subjects being treated with Ampligen in late stage melanoma, sufficient to tell us whether or not, the signal is strong enough to move into phase 3 and further development of the drug. The funding by the grant through Roswell and NCI in a way sort of de-risks this concept, because they look at things very carefully to determine whether it's a good step forward using that money. But also these studies that we do, these, let's call them preliminary studies, these phase 2, if we have a strong signal in a well-run phase 2, that allows us to de-risk those future investments, because phase 3 trials are extremely expensive. So we need to know that we're on the right track before we go into that next tranche of research and development.
Tom, before we close, I understand Ampligen's being studied in multiple oncology indications. Can you provide a brief status of each of the programs with Ampligen?
Yes. If you look at the pipeline slide that was up previously, just take a quick look at that. You'll see, all the areas we're working in. And I refer you to our website where you can take your time to not only look at that slide, but recent publications related to data coming out of these studies. And it's consistently very positive data. And this is data not published by AIM ImmunoTech. This is data published by top cancer research centers with preeminent scholars in oncology research, talking about their findings using Ampligen, either alone or in combination with other immunological agents. And it's very powerful, information in those articles, which are also to be found on our website. Now, the ones I'd like to talk about in addition to what we're doing in melanoma, which I think is addressing your question, would be the key ones where the data has just come out this year and we think will be the drivers of our oncology program. First and foremost, the data published in late March in Cancers is very compelling because it shows that Ampligen as a standalone agent has tremendous potential to extend overall survival for late stage pancreatic cancer patients, both locally advanced and metastatic. So that's powerful data, and that was a study that was derived from subjects in what's the Netherlands approved back in late 2016 as an early access program to utilize Ampligen in these extremely late stage pancreatic cancer patients. And because of that data that was published, the Dutch government approved an extension of that program. So there are additional subjects from whom data is being derived, which will add to that body of knowledge. But we see a very strong future for Ampligen in late-stage pancreatic cancer. And then an abstract in April of this year was published at the American Association of Cancer Research. And that abstract, I urge you to read that because this is in the University of Pittsburgh study, University of Pittsburgh Medical School study run by Dr. Bob Edwards, who is a world preeminent researcher in gynecological cancers and specifically advanced recurrent ovarian cancer. This is the 45 subject phase two Ampligen plus pembrolizumab, which is also known as Keytruda, funded by a Merck grant. And a 45 subject cancer study is very expensive. And the interim data from that study was so compelling that they published this abstract at AACR. And that abstract shows in a cancer where in the late stages of it, there's very few therapeutic options, a 60%+ clinical benefit with an ORR, which is a combination of complete responses and partial responses, of approximately 35%. Now, I believe that that interim data was so powerful that it was important to get that news out. That's probably why it was published as an abstract at AACR, and that study is still underway. So we're only looking forward to the conclusion of that study for very powerful data about Ampligen as a synergistic agent with checkpoint blockade therapies.
Well, Tom, I hope you'll keep us posted on any developments with Ampligen, but thank you very much for the update today.
Well, thank you, Steve. It's always a pleasure joining you, and I look forward to our next interview.
Always a pleasure hosting you, Tom. That's Tom Equels. He's the CEO of AIM ImmunoTech.